So welcome to the last class. In this entire semester, we've already taken 36 classes, and today should be the 37th, and that is the last class. So today we will wind up the chapter that we are discussing on how to use MATLAB software, the ready-made functions available in MATLAB to solve various optimization problems. And we have already seen in the last two classes that how to solve single variable problem, single variable minimization problem, then we discuss and single variable unconstraint, then we discussed multivariable unconstraint. For that we have two different functions, that is fmin search and fmin unc, and fmin bnd is for the single variable. Then we will discuss for the constraint optimization problem, and in that the what is the function name, fmin cn constraint, no, con, fmincon, right. So we discuss how many subroutines or functions in last two classes. Yes, how many subroutines we have discussed, MATLAB subroutines? Four, right. One for unconstrained single variable, two for multivariable unconstrained. So these three for unconstrained, and the last one, the fourth one, is for the constraint minimization problem. Okay. Now today we will discuss, is it 37th? 37th class, no? Yeah, this is the last one that we discussed. Now tell me, in this, in the last class that we discussed, that is GF11 and GF22. Now tell me, GF is a matrix or no? Matrix, how many rows and how many columns? One second, think and tell me. Is it 2 by 2, 1 by 2, 2 by 1? Yes. 2 rows, 1 column, very good. How did you, how could you tell the correct answer? Yes. See, what is 1, 1? This one represents the first row, this represents the column number. So this represents the element of the matrix GF. See, located at the first row, this is the row, first row and first column. And this GF21 corresponds to the element that is second row, first column, right. So this is a column vector. So it is a two rows, first row, second row, but only all are situated in the first column. So this is the way we, in any matrix, any particular element can be addressed using this common bracket. Within this bracket, write down the matrix name. Then within this common matrix, write down first the row number, comma, then column number. Just like earlier we said X within bracket 1 means what? It is a one row matrix, the first element. X within bracket 2 means what? It is the first, it is the second element, but only in one row. So there we need to mention the various the rows and column. But this is 2 by 2 matrix, and this is the way we have to specify it. Is that clear? So, and what about the F, it is a scalar or a vector here? Yes, yes, in this particular one, F, it is a scalar, it gives you only one number, nothing else, right. So there is no rows, no column there, so only it is a scalar, but GF is a matrix which is 2 rows, 1 column, that is why this is 1, 1 and 2, 1. So, and what about the X, is it a vector or scalar here? It is a vector. And how many elements are there in X? Two elements, X1 and X2. So X is a vector, GF is a vector, but F is a scalar. So in MATLAB, you need to specify the dimensions or the area size, it automatically understands. So both variable and matrices are defined as only the name of that, only one simply name you give it, it understands that whether it is a variable or it is a, depending upon how many elements are involved there. So did anybody try without this line? Did it work or no? Yes? You didn't get time, I think, because last I think you went 6:15 and today you got away. Also, oh, you have another class after 6:15, okay. Okay, so you try, when you get time, you just ignore this line and ignore this line and try, if you give it like this, whether you're working or not. Okay, now tell me in this one, how many matrices are there and how many rows and columns are there here? So see, G. So it is only one matrix, right? And how many rows are there? Two rows and two columns. Because you see, the first, this is first row, this is the second row. This is first row, first column. This is second row, first column. This is first row, second column. This is second row, second column. Right? So GG is a 2x2 matrix. That's why it is written like this. And why you have written GG as a 2x2 matrix? Because there are two G constraints are there, G1 and G2. But F only one function. So there, that's why there is no need of any taking the second column. Only one column is sufficient. Two row, one column. Yes, any doubt? Yeah, but here not required. In this function, Hessian matrix is not required to be reported out. But specifically, if you want Hessian matrix, also you can put another one, comma, Hessian you can write down, and Hessian you can, no problem. But in this particular one, it is not required. But if you report anything extra also, there is nothing. So here it is not required. Okay, so this is over. fmincon. Okay. Now, let us discuss another two MATLAB functions which are dedicated for solving the optimization problem using non-traditional technique. And in our syllabus also, we discuss two non-traditional techniques. The first one we discuss is genetic algorithm and second one is simulated annealing. In MATLAB, to solve the genetic algorithm, the function that you have to use is GA. GA is the short form of genetic algorithm. So let us solve this example. So minimize Himmelblau function, the same Himmelblau function, starting point is 0, 0, it is x1, 0, x2, 0, but you have to use genetic algorithm of MATLAB optimization toolbox. If you remember, the same example we solved it manually, isn't it? We solved an example, the same Himmelblau function we solved it. Now we had supposed to solve it using genetic algorithm. So open that optimization toolbox, select genetic algorithm, then various fields will be there, where to field what, that you should only know it. That's the only technique. And then press start, it will give you the result. Okay. So please enlarge it. So here, when this optimization toolbox, that screen will come up, in solver field, you select GA. Then it also explains what is GA, this is genetic algorithm. Suppose you forget what is GA, but still the whatever it is there, the full form is also given here. So select GA in the solver field. So when you press, click here in the this arrow down, that drop down menu will come here, from there you select GA. Next. Next is problem. In problem, under fitness function, earlier it was objective function, I think, or function it was written. But here it will be written fitness function. So there you write down the file name hf.m. But dot m is not required to be mentioned here. Simply write down GF, HF. We will discuss what is to be written in HF. Okay. Then at the rate. File name preceded by the symbol at the rate. This you have to key in the field fitness functions. Here it asks how many variables are involved. So here two independent variable, the unknown variable, so x1, x2, so just write down 2 here. Then nothing else you are required to, because it is an unconstrained problem. So constraints nothing is there, so you don't have to write down anything. Then simply place start, it will give you the result. So after 51 iterations, the result gives you that the function of the objective function value is 0.0156. So almost tends to 0. Yeah.
In every problem, we are getting the answer after some iteration. Is it possible to get the value?
it doesn't give you. MATLAB doesn't give you. Or maybe there, let us find it out. Any options will be there.
Sir, we can limit the number of iterations. So
here you cannot limit the where it is given.
Right, right side, sir, we can limit.
One minute. Where it is? Initial score, initial range, creation, initial population, population size, population size. देखो थोड़ा नीचे जाओ तो नहीं उसका नीचे और थोड़ा वो नहीं है इतना ही है it was given and then you can specify there so it will stop there and give you the result yeah so I think in the right hand side it is there na
yes sir
option is there yeah so there is a I am not able to remember there are various operators various it options are there so there you can select this one okay now okay and then this is the value of the objective functions and then the value of x1 is 2 here and value of x2 yes value of x1 is 2.978 see it is not giving exactly 3 here it is tends to 3 close to 3 it will gives you 2.973 that is x1 and x2 value is 2.014 that is approximately equal to 2 right so this is GA let's see simulated annealing then nahi before that what is HF so in HF that you have specified HF I have given name Himmelblau functions right so function as usual the first word should be function it will return the variable y so y is equal to hfx and in x the first element let us store it at x1 second element of x let us store it at x2 now x1 and x2 is a variable and then we write down x1 dot cap 2 means x square plus x2 minus 11 then whole square so put a bracket here then dot cap 2 this is the first term second term is x1 plus x2 square so dot cap 2 is x square minus 7 then whole so put a bracket then dot square see here you can also eliminate this line also wherever x1 is there just write down x within bracket 1 that also within one line you can write it down no problem this is another way just to reduce the putting brackets nothing else is it clear either if you want to remove this line fine no problem but instead of x1 everywhere you have to write down x within bracket 1 and in place of x2 you should write down x within bracket 2 so HF is Himmelblau function here no need to write down any gradient functions or that kind nothing is there if gradient was there so it is only the Himmelblau function what is that value objective function you have to mention it here no it automatically takes it in MATLAB please remember that one in MATLAB although it is a fitness function there you have to write down only the objective function and similarly but in MATLAB you have to convert it to minimization one this one and our problem was already in minimizations isn't it so you don't have to take minus of this one or 1 by this one straight away here fitness function is the objective functions because in MATLAB everything it first converts to minimization then it solves it that's the way yeah your doubt is very much pertinent every time also I had also doubt like this so here it although it writes fitness function value you have to write down the objective functions yes any other doubt okay so number of variable is 2 constraint keep it blank because there is the unconstraint problem and then start okay 51 iterations objective function value is 0 final point is 2.978 2.014 now let's discuss the last problem that is 11th one that is simulated annealing So minimize the same Himmelblow functions starting from, let's take any arbitrary point 2.5 2.5, but you have to use MATLAB optimization toolbox. Here the function to be used is simulannealbnd. Simul for simulated, anneal for annealing, bnd means boundary specified. Bounds are specified, initial point has to be specified 2.5 2.5. Okay. Dekho. So everything remains same. Only thing is that in solver, select this simulated annealing algorithm. Click here in this arrow, drop down menu will come. From that, there will be so many options will be there, out of which select this simulated annealing algorithm. In short, simulannealbnd. Yeah, there is a mistake here. Write down 2.5, 2.5. Yeah. So it's a mistake, 2.5. So objective function value, the same file name, whatever we have created for the genetic algorithm, the same file name will work. So at the rate HF Himmelblow functions and nothing else, simply press start, it give you the result. You have to specify only two things. One thing is your objective function file, second thing is starting point. And in starting point it should be 0 semicolon 0, right, but actually it should be 2.5 semicolon 2.5. Okay. So objective function value, it gives 10 to the power minus 9, so almost 0. Okay. And x1 is 3, x2 is 2, might have been the decimal point, but rounded off to 3 it has given. But how many iteration it has run? 2777 iteration it gives you the result. Okay, everything remains same GA, only thing you have to specify this, same everything same, only instead of GA you have to write down simulated annealing. Thank you. So with this we complete the optimization toolbox chapter, and with that your course for this semester is over.